Amporo, who made the remarks on the sidelines of the 8th stakeholders briefing session, organized by the Auditor General's office at Keetmanshoop, say that the high unemployment rate at the town makes it difficult for residents to pay rates and taxes. The acting CEO, however, thanked pensioners for always paying their bills.
We have got the issue of the historical debt that has been way coming from what was long overdue. And we are in the process of ring-fencing our NAMWATER and both the NAMWATER and the NAMPOWER accounts.
The town council says that they are currently at an early stage to drill boreholes to supply a portion of the water demand directly to residents.
In fact, that will initially, yes, it will, yes, in on the long run, assist us to recoup that directly from our customers and pay off both the NAMWATER and NAMPOWER debt.
Meanwhile, Hilarita Gainkos, the acting CEO at the Maltaya Village Council, says the Village Council owes the two entities over $21 million.
We are looking at procuring prepaid systems that we'll be installing very soon, hopefully by the end of the year. As for electricity, the one option that we have is to implement the new tariffs that will also boost our revenue collection.
NAMWATER recently threatened to cut water supply to defaulting town and village councils, which prompted various protests from residents around the country. Na Tangwejimi, NBC News, Keetmanshoop.